गुड इवनिंग ऑल ऑफ यू. वेलकम टू कॉर्नर स्टोन ऑफ साइंटिफिक पब्लिकेशन और इंटरनेशनल वेबिनार सीरीज. एंड टूडे इज द पार्ट 4. इट इज प्रेजेंटेड बाय इनोवेटिव एजुकेशन एंड साइंटिफिक रिसर्च फाउंडेशन इन कोलेबरेशन ऑफ इनोवेटिव पब्लिकेशन. If you are having any difficulty regarding the audio and video of this webinar, then please let us know through the comment and question box. We will try to help it out. Please check your audio video settings before we start. Today's session is comprises with a 4 odd subdivided sessions. One is introduction, second is presentation by key speakers, question answers, and thanks for vote. Today's topic is Reference Manager Software. Know all about it, and we cover Mendeley, Zotero, and EndNote in this. The flyer of I would like to introduce Innovative Education and Scientific Research Foundation. It is a non-profit organization and working with the goal to help researcher fraternity to disseminate their research globally by publishing in peer review journal, by presenting conferences, research talk, seminar, webinar, etc. Our main vision is to promote scientific research globally and provide a platform to community that tends to improve the visibility of their work internationally. ISRF is an association of more than 3,000 members. For more information in details, please go through our website www.iesrf.org. Innovative Publication is a publisher in medical, dental, pharmacy, nursing, and allied sciences. Innovative publishes high-quality peer-reviewed open access article in all specialties. Here some reason is to publish in Innovative and experience their exceptional services. To know more, please visit www.ipinnovative.com and submit your manuscript at www.innovpub.org. So I would like to introduce today's speaker, Dr. Lalit Gupta. He's an MBBS, DA, DNB, Anesthesia, MNA, MS, Associate Professor in Anesthesiology and Intensive Care. He's from Maulana Azad Medical College and Associate Hospital, New Delhi. He has active publication in esteemed national and international journals. He is a reviewer and associate editor and editor-in-chief for more than 60 national and international journals. He has authored chapter in many books for both national and international levels. He also authored books, Synopsis of Anesthesia and Drug in Anesthesia and Critical Care. He is founder member of Anesthesia and Critical Care Foundation Society. He is a member of advisory board for International Conference on Technology for Education, Training and Business in collaboration with ARSEAM Foundation, and member of National Advisory Board Innovative and Scientific Research Foundation, and member of various societies also. His research interest is intensive care, remote area anesthesia management, difficulty ARDS, onco anesthesia, pain medicine, and palliative care. Welcome, Dr. Lalit.
Hello.
Yeah, welcome. And our today's speaker is Dr. Kedar Mehta. He is MBBS, MD, Community Medicine Assistant Professor in Department of Community Medicine, GMERS Medical College, Gothri, Vadodara, Gujarat. Due to unavoidable circumstances, Dr. Kedar is not able to join us, but I am very glad to inform you all that he shared his lecture presentation to us, and we enjoy this feast of knowledge on his behalf by Dr. Lalit Gupta, an expert of Reference Manager Software. If you have any question, ask them in question box at the bottom of your screen. We will try to answer as many as unique question as we can. If somehow we could not answer your questions due to time constraint, then you can email us your question info@ipinnovative.com or editor.isrf@gmail.com. Thank you. Now I would like to request Dr. Lalit Gupta to share his knowledge about Reference Manager Software. And I would like to all participants, if you are not able to join through Zoom because of lesser capacity here, so please go through the online live streaming from Facebook link, which is already shared at your mobile number as well as your email ID. Thank you.
Thank you, Nikita.
Yes, sir.
Now I will be sharing my first presentation. Can you give me the rights for share a screen? Yeah, thank you so much. So from here, I would be first thankful to Dr. Kedar that he has given the opportunity to present his presentation. Due to some unavoidable circumstances, Dr. Kedar is not able to physically present for this conference. However, he agreed to share his presentation. Now I am going to discuss, we are discussing the reference management software. What are these, how they are used, and what is their utility in a good research work? Thank you, Dr. Kedar Mehta. I am presenting on behalf of you. So coming to the reference management, a good research pay attention to detail in all of their work. That is, your work speaks. This is the motto of this reference management conference. The concept being referencing citation is a system used in your written work to indicate where from evidence, ideas, theories, facts, or any other information were found by providing a description of the sources. Or you need a bibliography where all the references are put at the end of the manuscript, or the cross-referencing where a given article can be checked or a reference quoted is given and you can check it from anywhere. So you need three types of referencing. Referencing at the end, general, bibliography, and cross-referencing. And when to add the references, when a quote is made, a method, a sentence as a concept, result published by somewhere else. Use other research ideas, any part of writing without attribution is a serious offense known as a plagiarism. And in the medical literature, it is taken as a serious matter. And sometimes the publisher, the writers, authors are pardoned for a particular time from publishing such work. Even though there is monetary punishment as well as some other punishments are also in place. So the question comes is why the references are so important? Well, acknowledging the contribution of those who have already done research on the topic. Yes, it must be. Avoid the plagiarism. As I told you, it's a criminal offense by giving credit to the original source of an idea, piece of information or research. Support your work with the authoritative work for the another author. Demonstrate your knowledge and familiarity with the topic that you have researched and help the readers of your work to find the original source of information or ideas that you have used. This is why references are important. But how are these put? Because there is a lot of references for a particular topic and people are often confused from where they should be put, how to use them. Well, everything cannot be referenced, but what can be referenced is scientific articles, book chapters in books, atlases, policies, guidelines, reports, social sources of the stats, personal communication, unpublished documents, web page, blogs, and nowadays in the Twitter, blogs, all these can be referenced in a particular way. But how they are can be referenced? There is a particular device, a method, methodology, which can be used for them. So how do you choose reference for an article from the hundreds in your database? You have lots of articles, but you need a particular reference for that. There limit references to the relevant in the only recent ones. Cite clear fairly. Do not cite if you have not read, because you are going to put a particular statement from a particular article, what you have only read. Check general style, is it Vancouver or Harvard, and it must meet with your general requirement. Keep a copy of your references handy at a particular time is not an easiest talk. It is one of the most tedious job while preparing a manuscript. So what should be avoid when choosing references for our articles? Articles we have not yet read, articles that are not yet published or in the pre-portal or the pre-publication form, websites like pages that are likely to the change, like the Wikipedia, which are oftenly changed by the authors or encyclopedias. So manuscript section where references are added are post-results discussions. When we are going to discuss introductions, yes, methodology, yes, and discussion, yes, except the results everywhere the manuscripts are referenced. And the citation styles we are using in this references are either the Vancouver, most commonly used worldwide, ICMJE, Harvard, Chicago, ASM, APA, and the variations names at all like bold, italics, abbreviations, punctuation, date of indexing, URL, ISBN, etc. There is a lot of things. And everything has to be uniform in a particular style. Suppose I am using the Vancouver style. Vancouver style is not a new style. It involves the combining pulse oximeter with clinical examination, which enhances the clinical ability to detect the life-threatening heart disease. There are the two references for this particular statement, 1 and 2. Now coming to the Richmond S. Warren C. Early Diagnosis of Congenital Heart Disease, Jor Neonatal, 2001. General is the Neonatal General, 2001 edition, 6th edition, 27 to 35 pages. So it is author number style, citation in text in the parenthesis like 1 and 2 or the superscript. It has always to be written. Only these two forms are the acceptable ones. Otherwise, it is more likely to be rejected. References appear on Arabic numbered list in the same like 1 and 2 in the Arabian or L or X in which they are cited in the text are never recognized. Now coming to the another important one, like the Harvard style. That is the multiple choice question based assessment are fairly common now. Yet not enough stress is laid on the training of the teachers on preparing good MCQs. There are very few studies reporting use of item analysis of MCQs in the medical education from India. Now I have to suppose 1998 was Shah et al. In 2001 and Sarin et al. 1998. They published it, but I have to reference them. So Sarin, comma Y et al. 1988 item analysis of published MCQ Indian Pediatrics 3511 page number 1103 to 1105. And similarly 2001. So citation in text is author followed by et al. At the year of publication, both including in the parenthesis. We will be discussing it more in the second part of this presentation. Well, I will be telling you about the Vancouver and other styles. References list is alphabetically arranged as per the author surname. It is always remember it is the surname. Like Y is the surname. Here Sarin is the first name. I would suppose the name is the YK Sarin. So Sarin will be put in the first as a surname. And not numbered, it is not numbered 1 and 2, okay? So reference management softwares, they are the packages which are both commercially available as well as freely available on the net. The few of them are the Zotero and Mendeley EndNote and Colmes. While the Mendeley is highlighted red because it's the only software which is free and it is widely used. And it is one of the most easiest used software at present in the market. So let's discuss about the Mendeley. In the second part of the presentation, we will be discussing the paid like the Zotero and the EndNote. So in this presentation is mainly focused on the Mendeley. Now, what are the advantages of joining such a using such a software? Storing, consulting references, downloading entire reference from internet, example PubMed. It is very easy with such a single click. Assure the quality of the references. They all are the PubMed indexed or they are from the citations. Short by the author, date, type, keyword, journal, etc. As per the requirement of the journal. Such library anytime and use booleans. That is and or not can be used. Link to Word, PDF, copies of article are always available by these softwares. And ability to link your notes on article on just a single click is easily available. So while you are writing an article, insert references into text from the databases, automatic update of reference numbers, and automatic change of the format of references. These are the few advantages which will be discussed in the coming presentations and how it is done. So coming to the Mendeley, the demonstration of Mendeley, I will be giving a short glimpse of how to use the Mendeley. Because Mendeley is one of the most easiest software which everyone can use on his desktop or laptop. So what is Mendeley? Coming to the Mendeley is a free reference manager and academic social network which can help organize your research, collaborate with others online and discover the latest research. So Mendeley, I would say it is automatically generating bibliographic softwares. It's collaborate easily with other researchers online, anywhere, any place. Easily import papers from other research softwares. Find relevant papers based on what you are reading. Access your papers from anywhere online. Read papers on the go with our new iPhone app. So Mendeley is now compatible with the iPhone and they are preparing a Android version which will be soon available in the market. And quick and simple installation. Okay, now how to use it? I am going to tell you step by step. So go to the site www.mendeley.com. From there you can download the software or just you can sign and download on the site itself. This is the sign of the Mendeley, M, capital M in the red is the Mendeley. Create a shortcut on the desktop. Up to 1 GB is the storage, the free cloud storage, which is given by the Mendeley above the paid service. After that, if you need more storage, you can pay for the extra GB if you need. So suppose once I have installed, it is on my desktop and I want to use it. How I will use it? I will be showing to you the same. Now I have installed that Mendeley desktop. It is coming like this. And it is showing me complete my computer desktop screenshot where I have the library, authors, all documents. Then how it is like it seems. So first on the my left hand side, there is a file, edit, view, tools, help. This is the icon bar. From there is a search bar on the right hand side. Below there is a my library where I have the everything like welcome to Mendeley, documents, recently edit, favorites, need revive, review, my publication, unsorted type. Then there's a filtration by the author. That is, they are by the alphabetically from A to Z, all the per the authors and their surnames, it is compiled. And then
There is all their authors in the, when you are seeing all documents in the expanded form, you can see all the articles and authors here, the titles of your articles, the year of publications, and when you add it to your desktop, or it is published and it is added to your collection. So now zooming, I am zooming this var part, icon part, in the next slide, where you have five options of add files, folders, share, and synchronization. From here, if I add click on the add files, so I will be giving all the documents present at present in my, like, authors, and add there's the options of files, single articles, folders, watch folder, or add mentor manually. From here, you can synchronize with your web anytime. So whatever you are doing on the desktop, it will also be synchronized with the Mendeley on the web. So I can click on the file. Here I have add files, folder, watch folder, entry manually, and synchronization by FY, single click. So these are the articles which I have just downloaded. And how I will do it, I will show it now. From here, I will choose the view. View can there, I will go to the library as a table or as a citation. I can choose anything. Suppose, and show documents details. That is, everything is shown here. These are the particular citation styles. I have clicked on the citation styles. American Political, to the Harvard, Chicago, Vancouver, Nature, Modern, whatever you feel like, or more styles you can click. There are only more thousands of type which are easily available on the net. It will be open on your desktop. But suppose I am interested only in the particular type of slides, I will go to the Vancouver. From Vancouver, I will go to the tools. Tools can then invite colleagues, install web importer, install MS Word plugins, check for the duplicates. It is, everything is available. In the next step, I will install the web importer. That is, whatever I am reading on the web, just a single click will install on my desktop in this install web importer. And install MS Word plugin, it is very important, because when you are opening your document in the Word, you will get the plugins of the Mendeley. When you are going to view in the view section in the tools there, you can get the MS plugins. And from there, you can just single click. It will automatically arrange your articles as well as your citations in the particular order which is required by the Vancouver style, which I had earlier chosen in my presentation. So now coming to the site Mendeley.com, where I have the Discover Papers and Mendeley. This is the sign where I have signed up and logged. Import to the Mendeley. Yes, whatever I am seeing, whatever article I am finding it, I can import to the Mendeley from this click. From there, now suppose I have opened this my Microsoft Word and I'm going to write an article. Now here I will use the references. In the references, there is a style insert citation. Now this is the particular Mendeley software. This is the insert citation software. Yeah, this what I have highlighted now. Okay, you got the software. You have installed on the web. It is now synchronizing with your articles, whatever now you are writing. Suppose inserting reference as an example. I am writing, India is one of the highest TB burden countries in the world and account for nearly 26% of the global case. And there are the 3.1 and 2.2 million TVs are respectively. And suppose I want to, since 1997 to the up to the 5 years, I want to add the citations here. And I have written it from somewhere, but I have to code that. And I can easily forget from where I have taken until and unless I have written on the paper or I have given the some screenshot or printout from this. So now there is a reference one and reference two. I have put in the bracket, bracket one, bracket two. How it will work? I will just go the insert citation in the Mendeley. Mendeley, I have saved it from Mendeley. Press F1 or add in help and insert is a new citation, alter plus M. The keyboard is the keys. Insert citation, my library, search by the author by the my library, go to the Mendeley. Next, okay, and okay karte hi, I will get this type of thing, WH and Ajay Kumar, where I have got the WHO reference number 1 and 2, that is the WHO global TV report and HIV testing, which I had earlier shown. So it is now automatically added from there, what I have read, because I have synchronized my desktop with my Mendeley web settings, WHO, and this one, you can cite it from here and cancel, because this was the article I was reading. If I click here, this will go directly to the my MS Word page. And it will be as a one, it will be saved there. Press cite and you will get it here like this. To WHO 2012, okay? And say American Politics, you can always use the style, whichever you want to do. American Political style, American Psychological, Nature, Vancouver, whatever. You can select it from, suppose I am selecting the Vancouver style in this base one Vancouver. This is the WHO of the part which I had downloaded from my web page. Now part 2, that is about the TV program, same things, 5 years, 2, next, insert the bibliography, the same thing, I will insert it and it will be the reference section from their page, from my collection, it will go continuously to the here. So it is as simple as, you know what you have read, you have know what you have saved in your presentation, you just click there and it will come directly from the MS Word plugin to your first page. So these two were the references which I was discussing about in my web page references, and it is now added as a part 1 and part 2, that is WHO and Central TV references. So keep the cursor on the text, highlight the line and scope for the editing the text, where you can editing anything about them. So this is what in short Mendeley is. So Mendeley is a free software which gives a lots of advantages about the saving of the documents and how can use them with their citation, where you can take a particular citation, particular article, you can click on the article on PubMed or wherever you want to do. You just click on the Mendeley settings on your web page. It will be automatically come to your collection. And when you go and you will put it, it will directly transfer to your MS plugins. Saying, I will acknowledge Dr. Ajay Kumar and Dr. Chavda from the Vadodara and the Union for this beautiful presentation. Now Mendeley is complete. Now I will go to the different software, which is the second part is which is the other things are the paid versions. What I was discussing is it was only the free versions. So the other ones are the what can I do and what can I do with it. So as I told you, just a quick revision for 2 in 3 slides what we have just now read. Typical researcher writing a paper and you want to know, he needs to see all the references what he is showing in the computer screen. Either he can write it here or you can use a reference or a bibliographic software, because most of the time this is the common reason why your thesis, your paper, your articles are not accepted and it is given for again and again and again for the changes and for your for the reviewership. So this is thing we are just remembering where the problem starts. It is in the article, book and conference paper. These are the three things which most of the people are writing. There is nothing else except that you can write. You can either write an article, a book or a conference paper. And when you are write your paper from all three these references, what you need? You need the citations. Yes, articles, other articles published by other ones, the books which is giving the citation of the your present work, and the conference paper which are already published somewhere, now act as the citations for your paper. Now the thing is that how will you manage these citations? Okay, references list, bibliography, there is a lot of things where you need to write and you always get confused and your paper is now rejected because you don't know how to write the citation. So ultimately, because there is a lot of typing mistake, your style is not proper. References, there are a lot of references which are not proper, or they are upside down, or they are increasing or decreasing order, the order is not maintained, or you are writing the mistakes, how to print them, how to write them. So what happens? You need a proper reference management software which gives the proper credit to others for your work, adds credibility to your work by showing the valid information source that you have written something and you have achieved something from the other thing which are quite as valid as your own presentation. Show how your work is related to your previous work. It avoids the plagiarism, and for reference to fulfill their function, it must be accurate. Make sure that all the information in the citation, for example, author list, article title, general title, volume, year, page, everything is accurate and it should not be misspelled. So what I told you in the previous presentation in the Mendeley, that there is a many styles, while the most common is the Vancouver one, where we have the 3S, strict style syntax. That is, everything should be a proper way. It should be in the style and it should be in the order. How? Suppose I am discussing an article, new strychnine, an unusual cause of post op non-cardiogenic pulmonary edema. This article is published in Indian Journal of Clinical Anesthesia in the year 2015 with the authors Gupta L, Dwivedi G and Bhaduria P. Now how will I will need to write this citation in a proper way so that it is accepted? For this I have the authors is Gupta L, Dwivedi G, Bhaduria V, the year of publication, that is 2015. Then neostigmine, the title, Indian Journal of Clinical Anesthesia, the general name, issue 2x2, second edition, and it is the second part of the second edition. The 111/113 is the page number, that is 111 to 113. And then there is the date of indexing with the journal, that is the DOI-ORG, which is the digital object identifier, which shows the date of indexing. Okay. Now coming to the type of the information, what you need from a citation manager to add in your paper, because you have database, you have full text paper, and then you need a reference manager where all these can be synchronized and you can put in your work. How it works? Because while literature information management, It is important. Common error, lack of organization. You don't know, you just forget how to organize the references. You download and forget where you have downloaded and you how to arrange them. Improper file mining means you are putting the reference 2 of the reference 1 and the text is now changed. No classification, you are not classified in this type of the citation, it should be published. And downloading the same item again and again because you are not keeping their account. And then there is a hardware issue. Suppose you have saved as a soft copies in your computer and your computer crashes, it all becomes failure. And your desktops are changing from one to another place. You are going from one laptop in the office, desktop at the home, and you want to use it altogether, you cannot use them until unless you need a proper software for the reference management. So coming to the history, after you have read the Mendeley, you should know a particular history of the software, how they are evolved from the proprietary article to the free open source, which is with the before the 1980s era. Then 1980s comes the reference manager, EndNote, Bookends, where some of them were paid, some of them free. In 1990s, there was a Pylographer and Biblioscope, which was soon faded out because they were not in the particular use and they were very hard to understand. And then since 2020, 25 new softwares, including Mendeley and Zotero, have been launched, which are used as a citation manager. Now, I am giving a glimpse of this glorified history of these reference management softwares. Index Medicus, that is the books which were used as a complete references for most of the articles, 1878 to 2004, it was published, which later on becomes Index Medicus to the PubMed in 1997 onwards. And now still it is in the work of the PubMed, where it has the PubMed is supposed to be the it is a library which has all the US based national library, which has all the citation and articles arranged in a particular member. Then what happened? Then comes the DOI, that is the in the 2000 year, which is the DOI cross reference and the a citation DOI directory prefix, which becomes a very instant hit with the publisher as well as the author, because it gives, you can check it with the DOI value, the digital object identifier, anytime, any place, and you can remember it very easily if you are written. Then 2006 era came with the Google, which has the docs and spreadsheets and the buzzwords, where you can write and document and you can save it. After that, Joho Writer and Office Live Workshop. It will all becomes with the help of the Microsoft. However, they were very hard to understand. Then what happened? 2009 was the era when we saw lots of citation manager, including ResearchGate, EndNote, Zotero, ReferenceWorks, Reference Manager, CiteUlike, Mendeley, Microsoft Word, Jav References, LabMeeting, and BibTeX. Some of them became very popular like Mendeley and EndNote and Zotero, while others lost their shine in the meanwhile. And then the came 2009, the ORCID ID, that is Open Researcher and Contributors ID, which also has the all records of your publications in a particular era as in a particular format, which has the working together motto, working together to align the global network so that anyone, any can time can research you. So what do you find out? We found out that as the evolution has progressed from the site you like, Twitter, friend feeds, these were the new additions, which were the previously citation manager. Now you can use the Twitter as a, some people have used it and they have quoted that it was published on the Twitter. So it is to be indexed. Article level metrics, research blogging and reference manager. Ultimately to compile all these and to write all these in a particular needs, you need a reference manager. So reference manager is the whole soul thing which saves you from lot of hassles in publication. Now coming to the popular reference management tools, EndNote, Mendeley, Zotero, ProCite, RevWiz, and WriteNode, where we have discussed little about organize, annotate, and manage your references, import references from online databases, library catalog, and PDFs. It create in-text citation and formatted bibliographies, share references with other researchers, and work on your reference anytime, anywhere, so that whether in the office, desktop, you're in the library, you can access them and you can use them. Now coming to the just a comparison of the popular reference management tools. They are from the RefWorks, which is the cost of nearly $100 every year or free at any subscription academic institution. It integrates Microsoft Word. It can capture a web page to record, create a record. Yes, it can. Then the Zotero, this is the free open source, which is very, very important. Yes, it opens with the Open Office, Microsoft Office, as well as the Open Office, and it can capture your creative word. EndNote, it is a paid software, $250. It is very costly. It is, I think it is the costliest one, and it has the lots of feature which is not present in the others, which I will be discussing shortly. Mendeley and CitationAC both are the free. They both open with the Open Office, as well as they record, capture a web page to create a record. So Sync, Zotero, Mendeley are the two main softwares which are used as a free and open source. While EndNote is for the academic institution or in the research institutes where the research work is done, EndNote is more popular. So coming to a recap of the what we have just read in the Mendeley, it is a free reference software. Desktop version is available across platform, Windows, Mac, Linux. It is available. It is available in various version, desktop, web, mobile. Mobile version in the present only in the iPhone at present. Android version is coming very soon. Plugins for word processor, MS Word is present in the Mendeley. It creates groups and share your personal library and automatically exports them in the popular Cython formation, which is easily read and can be easily transcribed anything where whenever you need them. So coming to the Zotero. Zotero is the another software which is the open Firefox type of web browser. You go to the website www.zotero.org and you can install the Zotero from there, download. After installation, you just have to restart the Firefox. Okay, so you go to the site from the Firefox, you just download it, install it and restart the Firefox. This is what is done. Okay, once you have done Zotero, it will be on your, this is my Firefox. In the Firefox, now I have the Zotero at the right hand corner least. In the lowest right hand corner, I have the Zotero installed on my page. So whenever I open the PubMed page or I search from the Firefox to go to the PubMed, here I can see my Zotero, where I have the click on the Zotero logo in the bottom right of the browser and I can find out anything with this. When you click, you can have the PubMed left column Zotero libraries and collection, which has as well as the tags like keywords, which you can have like the thrashes, ILS, CBHA, and middle columns items which are contained within the selected library. Means these are all the publications along with their author's name by the name of the year and the date added as we seen in the Mendeley. While the right column has the information about a selected item like item time, journal articles, promoting developments, author wise, whatever you need a information about, you can just click and you will have the full information. Suppose I have clicked the first one, I can get the item was the journal article, the title was promoting development and use of the systemic reviews in a developing country, author yourself, author, the all name of the authors are given and the abstract introduction short is also available. So Zotero is much easier to use if you know how to use it. Left column, middle column and right columns. Okay. Then you want to add, like I shown you in the Mendeley, where you have to just click on the add folder, create collection to organize your references. To create a new collection, click on the new collection. This one, this box is the new collection. A box will appear promoting you to name your new collection. You can choose any name, suppose XYZ, yeah, you can choose the ILS, laboratory strengthening, you can use Chacha Nehru, whatever you want to keep it, and click OK. Your collection will appear in the left column. These are my, suppose these are my the libraries 1, 2 and 3 which I have created. And this is also a thrash, which is the, when you are deleting something, it will go directly to your recycle bin. Okay, next is that in the middle one, create a Zotero bibliography is as simple as it is in the Mendeley. Select the items. You have selected a post 5 or 6 area first articles. Then I will right click the selected items. Now choose the option create bibliography from the selective items. A new dialog box will appear. Now it has opened. Okay. Choose the citation style. Suppose I used to choose the Vancouver. It will come down in the Vancouver method. Choose the format RTF or HTML web page. It will be saved like this. And then you have to click the OK. So this all comes only on the right click of your mouse. Zotero is very popular as such, but it still have some limitation. And what are these limitations? The limitations being, it does not work with the internal Explorer or IE. Suppose if you don't have the Mozilla Firefox, it won't work in your desktop because it is not still incorporated with the Internet Explorer, which is the main software of the Microsoft. It's proprietary nature of the browser, but can install standalone on Windows OS. You can use it as a standalone software where it will be installed like other software in the desktop. You will click on the Zotero software on the desktop icon shortcut. It will open your whole this Zotero software. It removes duplicate items manually. You have to do it. It cannot. The Mendeley can do it, but you cannot. Suppose you have selected two papers and they have the same name there on the, you have selected on the two different days. You cannot delete one of them. You have to do it manually. It does not have as many as reference styles as a refros or EndNote. EndNote, I told you, it is the private software. It is paid and it has lots of limit expansions. So you can use any reference you can use, but not in the Zotero. And problem of the storage is always there. While 1 GB data was free in the Mendeley, here is the 2 GB. After 1 GB, you have to pay $20, which is equivalent to $1.6 per month per year. For 6 GB, $60, and for the unlimited, you have to pay $120 per year. That is equivalent to $10 per month. But most of the time, you just becomes 1 GB is enough if you are not doing much of research work and you are occasional writer. However, if you are a professional writer and you want to write as many as research paper, meta-analysis, you need a proper storage. Then you have to buy it more than 2 GB at the rate of $20 per year. So coming to the most important software, which is the paid one, and is a lot of expansion, is the EndNote. EndNote Web is a commercial reference management software package used to manage bibliographies and references when writing articles and meta-analysis. Users can add references to a library manually or via importing or exporting via the program. Via PubMed, users can select citations, select a specific format and save them as .txt text files. So if you want to read something over all this, all the information I am going to discuss is available on the Wikipedia with the 26 April 2009 edition. Now, you know, you will be surprised that the earliest paper, which was for the EndNote Plus, and in the all praise, it was published in the year 1992. As I told you, EndNote was pre-2000 software, which is still in the most important software place. It is hard to imagine a reprint file management and bibliography generation program that does more than EndNote Plus. That is, it is showing EndNote Plus is the endless program. Not only does it automatically assemble bibliographies from inserted in text citation, it also incorporates many powerful searching features to help manage those growing reprint collections. That is, it was in the 1992 when people realized the strength of these reference management software, and they could see the whole of the research process becomes so easy with these software that they published a proper research article on this EndNote Plus, that is the computer software reviews. So let's come how to use the EndNote. For this, you cannot use EndNote such as. There is a WHO collaboration program, that is the Health Inter-Network Access to the Research Initiative, also called as the HINARI Network. You have to first go to the HINARI Network page. You have to log into the HINARI software. Before logging into the partner publisher services like EndNote, log into the HINARI sites using the URL www.who.int/HINARI/. So once you goes to the HINARI software page and you log into the HINARI, the second thing will be the reference. Once you are logged into the HINARI content page, click on the reference sources to access the EndNote Web. So here you will click the access the content. Access the content where you will get this lots of things. A to Z, all these are general collection, book collection, and the reference sources. Now I have chosen from here access to the content, the EndNote. Browse reference software, just go back, access the content, reference sources. I clicked on the reference sources and I found the browse reference sources where you have all AP policies, BMJ best practice to the or, and there is an EndNote Web. Using the reference sources A to Z list, access EndNote Web, one of the three options for this bibliographic software. So you can either go to the EndNote Web or you can directly go to the EndNote page. This is sign in page for the EndNote Web account where you can, if you are new, you have to sign up. Otherwise, you can directly log in if you have earlier registered. Click on the sign up for an account to complete this process. You have logged in, you have reached the sign in page. Then once you have done, you have logged in on the EndNote page, you are getting three types of things. Collect the data, organize the data, and format the data. That is author, title, and page management. This is same as all in the references with the Mendeley, Zotero, means collection, organization, and formatation. In the collection, you search the online database, create a reference, and import the reference. Organize, create a new group, or many group, or find the duplicate references. While in the format, you format according to a particular bibliography like Vancouver style or citations, which while you read plugins and format a paper. So from the initial EndNote web page, you are given the option to my references, collect, organize, and format. See my references, collect, organize, format. So these are the four options which you get on the EndNote page. Now coming to the first one, the online search. You will find the collect references. The online research option can be used to retrieve references from the PubMed in the drop down list. However, this option has limited functionality. Plus, you are familiar with searching, saving in the HINARI PubMed version. Means until and unless you know how to use the HINARI, you cannot use this directly. From here, I can choose online EndNote page, PubLine. The new reference enables users to create new references by entering manually the relevant data in the bibliographic fields of the displayed template. The imported references is used to collect references saved as the text files from databases or another sources. So online research, my references, online collect references, online search step one, you go down the drop down menu, click on the PubMed, and then the this is the PubMed page, how it will open. Now, once you have suppose put a particular topic, avian flu and chickens, and you want to find how it is can the citations related to it can be saved. Suppose it has shown you 1 to 12 of 13 to 36 total articles, you selected the top 12. Yeah, whatever the 12 articles randomly you have chosen it. Now in the summary, it shows in 12 citations were previously checked are listed. So you have ticked them. Click on the citation manager. Here is the option for the citation manager. You click on this one. Send to citation manager, create the file. Manually display list the field that will be transferred to the EndNote where finally. So once you have done it, then you come to the My References. Okay, My References you have collected, come to the My References. In the My References, you have 12 citations from the avian flu and chicken. If you send the second option. From the My Reference option, displays the avian flu and chicken groups. Note that all the groups are displayed because like the My All References before, yeah, bad nets, what I have made it earlier, it is also available here. From all these citations, you can view the authors, year, title, and general information. This is author, year, title, and the general observation which you can see. And so you can copy, delete, or remove from the group any of the citation. Copy to the quick list, delete, remove. All these options are available once you click on the My Reference page. Okay. From there, in the next part, you have the collected, you have My References. Now you are going to the organize. How you are going to organize? Suppose you have the 30 and you want to in the organize manage my group sections. You will note that avian flu and chicken groups has 12 references and previously saved bad nets group has 17 references. So now you have 12 these and 30 these. You can create a new groups if you want some of the references from here to here. You can make a new groups or you can look at other groups that you have been created. So you can in the organize, you can find the duplicates, manage the groups, or you can create the new groups, whatever you want to have. Now the next action means you have organized the format, how you are going to format these things. Coming to the format, suppose I click on this format. Once you click on the format, you have the bibliography references software. Here I drop down to the BMC Medicine. Okay. In the format section, click the bibliographic styles drop down menu. From this page, you can choose a specific journal. Suppose BMC Medicine I have chosen. In the community use styles, list the Harvard writing styles. Here science. The second one is the science and we have choose the Harvard style. Okay, so you have now use your style writing style citation right and you have choose your journals from this formatting. Now the options what are left with us. Okay, this I've been from the bibliography. You can organize the avian flu and chicken references using the Harvard bibliographic style with the text file. You can save it. You have see references avian flu bibliographic style Harvard file format text. You can save it, you can email it, or you can preview and prevent it. That is, now there are the five options with you. You can collect the from the PubMed, from the EndNote. You can put in them your references. You can organize in the groups you want to have, or you can delete if you have re-added it. Then you can format it in a particular format. Like here, we have particularly formatted in the Harvard style. And this is the, you can now saving. You can save as a text file. You can email yourself or to your friend, or you can print out. To read it on a second way and how it looks when you print it out. Suppose this is the one, this you can give out, print the page. When you get the print of this, you got this type of publication page where you have all the publications. In the second, you have the email. You can directly email to you your friend where it will be email 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 types, or you can save as a text file on your desktop with either of three options. So if you want to know more about the EndNotes, EndNote has unlimited expansions. You can write from the EndNote Reference Management Software Module 5.1. It is available on the WHO site. Or you, if you want to learn from the Zotero, you can get a quick start guide available at the Zotero.support quick start guide and a beginner's guide to using Zotero by the branch available at SlideShares and guide to Zotero Mendeley.com. With this, I will say thank you. Ask me if you have any questions, because these are the brief descriptions how to use your softwares, and I think most of you now have the basic ideas how to use them and where to use them. With my experience, I am using Mendeley for many years and I found it much easy because it is not paid and it is easy to use. And once you have started using them, you can write any paper with them with the ease. Thank you very much.